Chairman, Commissioners, other constitutional officers, governmental boards, authorities, there are three items. And the first one is consideration to appoint two members to the Lee County Library Board of Trustees. And these are two vacancies for a three-year term. There are letters of interest from current board members, Valerie Benton and Eddie Henry. The next item was actually tabled at your last voting session. This is now on 74, page 74, A through I. This is consideration to approve a contract with Sturgis Web Services for a website for the Lee County Tax Commission. Funds have been included in next year's budget for this purpose. There was a question at your last meeting regarding the PayPal account monthly fee, which is on listed on the bottom of page 74B. I talked with Ms. Smith, the tax commissioner. She indicated that this would apply to in the office credit card scanners. She was not going to use those at the current time, but she would rather start out with the online website initially, which there's no extra fee for that, besides the fee that the Sturgis charges. The Sturgis did indicate that they would continue to honor within reason waiving the $6,000 standard initiation fee. And Mr. Chairman, since this is tabled at the last voting meeting, it is appropriate to vote on this matter tonight. And Ms. Smith is here tonight for any additional questions.
What's the will of the board?
I'll make a motion to approve.
I'll second.
All in favor?
Unanimous.
Mr. Chairman, last item under section 9 is consideration to appoint one member to the Southwest Georgia Community Council Board. This is a vacancy for a one-year term, and there is a letter of interest from Mark Satterfield in your package. Under county administrators' matters, the first item is consideration to adopt the fiscal year 2010-2011 budget resolution. The budget is scheduled to be adopted at your next meeting. The next item is a contract with the Georgia Forestry Commission for their continued services. The new contract doesn't indicate that the forest land assessment has increased from 4 cents to 10 cents per acre of privately held forest lands. And this will increase the amount paid to the Georgia Forestry Commission each year, as indicated on page 17. Item 10C is consideration to approve the department audits rental agreement. Audit building is located behind the courthouse annex, and this is just a continuation of leasing space to the state audit department. This rental agreement is found on page 81. Page 82 provides that the annual rental is $32,200. The last item is 10D, consideration to approve a correctional services agreement between the Southwestern Judicial Circuit Misdemeanor Probation Department and Lee County. This agreement begins on page 89. This is between the probate court of Lee County and the Southwest Judicial Circuit Misdemeanor Probation Department. It's a new program that has been funded by state grants in the last few months.
Any questions?
Next, we have the public forum. Six individuals will be allowed to request the Board of Commissioners for up to 2 minutes. We have three speakers tonight. First speaker is Mr. Tess wants to speak too. Ted Nelson, you're first.
Thank you, Board. The only thing I had was the talking about the landscaping and all that plan. If you have that many parking spots, first of all, you're almost doubling it. Do we need it? Do we have to spend all that money in one step, or if we process this so we don't have to spend all the money at once in two separate sets of construction? You know, maybe settle for some gravel in the back for now. The other thing is, if you're going to get rid of all that parking in the front, why not get rid of those 18 parts in front and make entry to the courthouse a whole lot easier for the sheriff to protect? Just a thought, looking at it from a standpoint of, you know, keeping the courthouse secure, which I'm sure is what the sheriff's going to want. You'll limit it to one entryway, or two rather than four, I'm sure. But I'd like to look at that in depth. I think we don't need to spend all that money at once, but to have a two-step plan might be better with the economy as tight as it is right now. Just my thoughts. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Nelson. Mr. Rowland?
I'm just going to stay seated. I received this letter today from the city of Leesburg wanting us to basically support them on keeping the Lee County Economic Development Authority in the city. And I would like to say that I support this simply because this is a function of the county government, and it needs to stay in the city. Most people these days go online, except for me, I'm computer illiterate, to handle this kind of business. I don't even know why it would need to be moved. Recently, we moved the headquarters of the library out to Oakland, and I know there's a need for a library in that area, but the headquarters of the library really should have stayed in Leesburg for the simple fact that Dr. Clay, he probably might want to go to the headquarters, and now we've made him have to drive 8 additional miles to add on to the 20 miles that he already has to drive. I mean, those people that live out in that area, could, if they need to come to the headquarters of the library, could come to Leesburg, those 8 miles versus Mr. Clay having to travel further. But I think that the Economic Development Board, I know I've heard it said, it's their money, they can do what they want to. But the fact of the matter is, we're the Board of Commissioners, we appointed these people, they fall under our jurisdiction, and I think we need to let them know, if we support this, that they need to stay in the city of Leesburg.
Thank you, Dennis. Commissioner Rowland. Next speaker would be Mr. Jeff Sexton.
I signed the wrong form, sorry.
You signed the wrong form.
Sorry.
Next speaker would be Mr. Wright. Mr. Wright here?
He's already signed.
Okay. Well, that takes care of the public forum. Now I need a motion from the Board to adjourn.
I'd like a motion to adjourn.
Second. All in favor?